Okay, we're getting back into tearing the Deville apart. And I wanted to go over something with you real quick. The insulation that you'll find in these trailers is very thin. And it's really not much insulation. But the main reason they put this stuff in here is for this. This is a reflective vapor barrier. And what it's in there for, the reflective part of it, plus the insulation, helps to reflect the heat away and give it some insulation, but it really doesn't do that well. The main reason it's in there is as a vapor barrier. What happens is water condenses on the inside of the aluminum skin when it cools off at night, vapor from the air, and it condenses and turns into water. Well, that would all drip into your wood and mess up your wood over time. It would rot it and so forth if it weren't for this vapor barrier. So that's basically the reason they put it in there. Plus it adds a little bit of insulative quality. What we're going to be doing is putting different insulation in when we put it back together and a plastic vapor barrier over the top of everything before the skin goes back on. That'll do a much better job of keeping the condensation down. So just wanted to go over that real quick with you. Also, I've noticed, and I'm sure you have, that I've had problems with the lighting out here in the front of the trailer. This time of the year, the sun is just the wrong place. I can't really get the kind of shade I want. And as a result, sometimes it's too bright. So we'll just have to put up with it because I can't seem to find any... I got the book out and can't find anything on the camera that I can adjust for that. So we'll just have to put up with it for now. At any rate, here we go. We're going to tear the wood out in the front of the trailer right there, and that way I can get the cabinets out. So here we go, we're gonna start tearing the wood out. One of the other things to keep in mind is as we take these wooden slats out here, we want to take a measurement and make sure that we get everything back in there the same size with the new stuff, because if the trailer sides are just a little bit too far apart, you'll never get the skin back on. Now, before you remove any of the slats, you want to mark them because they've got to come back to the exact same spot so that this window opening works. So we're going to mark it here and here. Down here is not really important. It's up here that's the most important. Mark that like that. And we're also going to mark it on the metal. I'm going to mark it with two different types of pen to make sure it stays there. Right here they notch the paneling so that it actually goes inside of the wall. So we're going to make some other marks and we'll take some measurements and write them down. We're going to make a mark right here. That shows where the window starts, and then we'll do the same thing on the other side, and we'll do that right now. And the other thing we want to do before we remove the wood is to remove the window trim. It's hard to do because the wood is rotten. As you can see, it just all falls apart when the tacks come out, so there they all are laying there. We'll clean those up and polish them up and stuff before they go back in. And so we'll put these aside for now. Starting to get a little crowded in here. And one more. There we go. So now we'll get this other bench seat out of the way. And we will remove this wood, this paneling. One of the tools that you need this kind of work is a sawzall. It's a reciprocating saw, and you can cut screws, metal, wood, all kinds of things. You can get it into places where you normally couldn't get anything else. So you need that. We have these corrugated staples that hold the wood together. We need to get those out. These will actually probably fall out, but I'm going to show you how the sawzall works for that. Slip it right in there. cutting right through them, see? So it makes quick work of problems like that. And we'll keep these so we can take a measurement. We'll be replacing the wood. Electrical wiring out of the way, which we're going to replace. See how easy that is? There you have it. We'll keep this little piece of hardware and shine it up. That's for the table, holds the table. Now, we'll have to take the sawzall and saw through all the screws that are holding these bench seat cabinets supports in, because 9 times out of 10 with these old screws and stuff, you just strip the head of the screw out immediately, and then you're left with having to cut the screws anyway, because they're 50 years old. So. Over 50 years. Well, 50 years. This thing is 50 years old right now. It's 1958. Yeah, it's 50 years old. But at least we have some room to work now. So now we'll go for these cabinets, take those out. So we'll slip this underneath. Saw through what screws are left. So there's that one, and we can reuse that in another trailer. There. I can use these in my guy trailer, the trailer I'm building for hunting and fishing, guy stuff. The kind of trailer that most women wouldn't want to be in, at least not for camping. Guy stuff. Well, there you go. As you can see, we got all the cabinets out. We got the kitchen cabs out and dinette cabinets out. So for the time being, what I'll do now is I'll remove all the fasteners for this tall cabinet here. Get it all ready to move out. But I can't actually pull it out until I remove the skin and the ceiling, because kind of held in there by that ceiling, so I got to lift that up in order to get this cabinet out. It gets upwards of 100 degrees and more out here. We've actually had some fairly cool weather, but it's also been kind of thunderstormy and a little windy at times, so I kind of got to watch what I do and when I do it around here. So tomorrow morning we'll attack that other cabinet and start working on the removal of the top. So with that, this is Mobile Tech signing off, and we'll see you next time.